I've seen so many experienced editors ignore these controls in the timeline track header area and continue to waste so much time with slow manual mouse clicks. So therefore today, I'm going to show you how to tame your DaVinci Resolve timeline with this tiny but essential switch called Auto Select. It does more than you think. So let's dive into what it is and how to use it. Most people think of this auto select control as the copy and paste selection button because it does do that. If you option click it, alt on a PC, it'll paste any clips in your clipboard onto that specific track. This tip alone is helpful, but what is Auto Track Selector? The auto select button tells Resolve, hey, pay attention to me if it's on or bright, or don't pay attention to me if it's turned off and dimmed out. But the reason this is so powerful is that it gives you a way to isolate your focus to a specific audio or video track without touching a mouse. And it can all be keyboard driven with the F1 to F10 function keys. So if you ever edit a timeline with stacked clips on top of each other, this is something worth mastering. Cut and insert paste with in and out marks is a great way to move an entire section of your timeline without manually selecting a bunch of little clips. First, pay attention to the Auto Track Selector button. I want to ignore the music track and leave it in place, so I turn off the A4 Auto Select. Mark the in and out points with I and O on your keyboard that you want to move. You'll see the A4 is dark, so it's only the highlighted area that we're going to cut out to the clipboard. Ripple cut with Command-Shift-X. Now move the playhead with either JKL to navigate to the new location for that section, or, bonus tip time, middle mouse click to pan around in the timeline. This is great for super long timelines. And insert paste, Command-Shift-V. Auto Select pays attention to the lowest track with Auto Select turned on, so another quick in and out marking tip is to use it to determine the duration of a title graphic. Just make sure the lowest track with Auto Select turned on is the title track layer. Mark the clip with X to automatically put in and out points on that clip, and you can see the title duration up in the viewer. Now, the one big exception to this auto select behavior is if you manually selected and highlighted a clip. If you manually selected a clip, the manual selection gets priority over the little auto track selector in the track header. The last examples show that you could ignore a track to cut and paste, but what if we want to ignore a music track to edit to the beat so we don't chop up the music? If sparingly used, cutting to the beat can pull an audience back in, and Auto Select is perfect for that. Just disable the Auto Track Selector in the audio track with the music, cut with Command B, or even better, ripple trim clips to the playhead with Shift Left or Shift Right brackets. And the music doesn't get cut at all, but you can still change the music volume level and work on it because it's not using the Lock Track button. In fact, I rarely ever use the Lock Track button because Auto Select does what Lock does and so much more. Auto Select helps you select individual clips that are stacked up high without touching a mouse. Disable Auto Select on tracks below what you want to select. Hit Shift V on the keyboard while the playhead is over the top of a clip. Now you can manipulate the selected clip however you need to. You could use the period or comma keys to nudge it left or right a little. And speaking of nudging, I want to nudge you to hit subscribe right now to my small channel called Creative Video Tips. I'm Chadwick, and I'm thrilled that you've taken the time to watch. This channel is here to help you craft stories that make a difference and stand out. I especially love digging into DaVinci Resolve, so maybe also hit the bell so you don't miss out on next week's tip. But we still have two more of my favorite use cases for Auto Select, so let's take a look at those now. The two main reasons I select edit points are either to trim them, make a clip longer or shorter, or to add a transition. Auto Select is significant here because I can blaze through an entire timeline one track at a time. And again, the lowest track that has Auto Select turned on gets the selection. Hit V on the keyboard to select an edit point, and it gets the green highlight. Use the up and down arrows to move through the timeline, adding transitions with Command T, or even do a quick trim with Command J or Command L. Quick trimming is even faster than dynamic trimming. Just rest your left thumb on the Command key while rolling the edit with JKL. I love this software. My word of caution when you trim and you have Auto Select disabled is you've essentially disabled the sync relationship to the rest of the timeline tracks. In Avid or Premiere, this is like turning off sync locks, basically taking training wheels off on your timeline. And like the amazing Editing Spider-Man said, Auto Select gives you great power, but also great responsibility to maintain sync. So I'll turn Auto Select switches back on to maintain sync relationships after I'm done doing what I'm doing. Option F9 and Option Command F9 are great shortcuts to toggle them all back on. The two main reasons I use Match Frame are either to find more footage from the same video or audio file, like an alternate take maybe, or if you need to pull original audio back down into the timeline. Sometimes offline editors, they work with a stereo mix track from set instead of the isolated microphones just for ease of use. But before the video gets professionally mixed, you want the individual microphones pulled back onto the timeline. Match Frame obeys the lowest turned on auto select track and will call up the exact timeline frame the playhead is parked on up in the source monitor with the source clip that it came from. It matches the timeline to the source. You can then overwrite edit only the audio back down to the timeline and work with all the isolated tracks for mixing. When you do a 3-point overwrite edit though, the big thing to note and pay attention to now is the destination control instead of the auto select control. Essentially, if clips have come from the source monitor, the monitor on the left side, use the orange highlighted destination controls. Otherwise, auto select is your friend, and here's the complete list of operations that auto select affects. Cut, copy, delete with marked in and out ranges. Paste, paste insert, deleting gaps, finding gaps, mark clip with in and out, selecting edit points, selecting clips, selection follows playhead, match frame, ripple trimming, insert and ripple overwrite edit. So you can see there's so much more to auto select than I can even cover in a single tutorial. But do me a favor and let me know in the comments how you like to use it. And if you're curious about other helpful DaVinci Resolve tips, click this playlist that's right here. And because there's so much more to learn, I'll see you in the next video.